That's a universal sound. I was just thinking about that earlier. Like, you could hear that anywhere and you would know what was happening. That's awesome. I like that kind of thing, you know? This is not sponsored by LaCroix. The stuff kind of sucks, but... What's up, everybody? Peter McKinnon here. Welcome back to yet another 2 Minute Tuesday. It's so great to have you here and see all of your smiling faces. Disregard the red marks on my forehead. I was just wearing a hat and figured I'm going to take it off and not wear it. Thus, moving on. Last week, we introduced photo assignments with the hashtag PM photo assignments. Some of you are asking, where do we post these? Instagram, of course. And a few of you also posted to Twitter, which is also fine. Basically, the two places you can hashtag things and find them. So many posts were made, so many people participating, diving into this challenge while we are spending our time at home, working from home, isolated, which was the theme of last week's episode. So let me get you up to speed if you're just chiming in now. Every week, Tuesday, 2 Minute Tuesday, is going to be photo assignments. So I'm gonna give you a theme. You're gonna go out and portray that theme as best as you possibly can with photography. Interpret it however you want. I'm gonna be playing as well. Last week's theme was isolation. So we had tons of submissions, all of which were amazing. I wish I could show every single one, but that's the point of having this series recur every week. Gives us something to do, something to look forward to, and a reason to be inspired because there are some awesome photos out there. Whew! You guys, come on. Where are you learning this stuff? Here? That's super cool. So let's throw 2 minutes on the clock. Not that we're gonna stick with it, but you know, for all time's sake, I'll do my best. And let's look at 10 photos that I selected from last week's photo assignment, isolation. Okay, photo number one from Cameron Chaffin is this shot here, titled Isolation, with probably the most used emoji right now on planet Earth. This just depicts what's happening in the world perfectly. You have a beautifully framed subject in the middle of a big city, seemingly empty, incredible texture, the subject wearing a mask no less, really just kind of sums up Earth right now. Really liked that, walking alone, as most of us are or should be. That's something that you'll probably look back on in years and be reminded of everything that, you know, the world has gone through together. Great job. Thanks for using the hashtag. Thanks for participating. Give them some love. Tell them you found them on Pete's channel. It makes this kind of thing more fun for everyone. From a user on Instagram by the name of Ulas Online. It was this great little picture of a little figurine looking out the window to rain. You can't really see what's out there. Kind of got to use your imagination. I love that this little figurine has a hood up. It kind of reminds me of my kids when they're looking out the window wanting to go outside, but it's raining or it's cold. I feel like it very much depicts the theme of isolation and not being able to go outside right now. It was unique. It was creative. And that's the kind of thing I'm looking for and hoping I can push you guys towards with these photo assignments, is not just doing what instantly comes to mind, but really putting some thought into how you can make this different. All right, next up we have Lost Lens from Toronto, Ontario. Oh, hey, neighbor. This was a very interesting, obviously creative composition. You have the words stay home written on a notebook with a Sharpie marker, and seemingly it's a jumbo marker because the subject is very small holding that Sharpie. So I was just very excited about the work that went into this photo and probably how to shoot it and then how to edit it and make it look good. That's a very good depiction of isolation, singular subject, with a message too. Moving on to the next photo. By the user ninth.i. What I liked about this photo was just the simplicity and relatability. This picture right here is probably what just about every photographer is doing right now. Sitting at their desk, going through archives, looking up old photos or things to post or things to re-edit or color in new ways. It just reminded me of me. And it reminded me of what most artists are probably going through right now. Just sitting at the computer with your feet up, pondering. That's why I liked it. Clean, simple, to the point. Good job, man. All right, next up we have a photo from Manu Coveney. This photo is super spooky. It's exceptional. But if you think of it, the caption says, "Outbreak, stay home, stay safe." The Grim Reaper in the street, which is kind of a depiction of like, if you go outside right now and disregard the warnings, that's kind of what could be waiting for you. That's what I got from it. Also, isolation theme on point, being that it's the only subject in an empty street, very much gets that across. It's scary. It's a scary photo. It's reality. I think that's why it's scary. Clicking into this guy's profile, there's a lot more like that. Exceptional photographs. You are doing a great job. Keep doing what you're doing. That's super creative. Freaks me out just a little bit, but I had to share it on here because I was moved by it and it caught my eye. It stopped me in my tracks. I really appreciated it for that reason. Give these guys a follow. Good job. One of my favorites. Next up, we have a photo from Klaus. Just cute. Isolation. Exactly is what it is. A singular subject separated from the many. Just liked how simple it was. Just a white background, all these little, what are these little things? Little figurines, little cribbage? Is this a board game? Should I know what these are? Either way, it's creative and I liked it. Moving over to Twitter for a second from the user Michael Duda. We have a frame called Isolated, which is a beautiful black and white photo of these four windows. You got some kids in the top left window wanting to go outside, feeling isolated inside. I saw a lot of portraits, a lot of stuff of people just kind of sitting randomly somewhere by themselves. This is kind of the same thing with people being isolated, but it was just like a nice, unique, fresh perspective of that from the outside in. I really liked it. The framing was great. The black and white was good. Reminded me of like an old photo you'd find stored in an ammo box back from the war in your grandparents' attic somewhere. I don't know. That's very descriptive and specific, but that's what I felt. Now I saved the last one because it's my favorite. I'm finishing things off for this photo assignment from Brian Mosheim. I'm sorry if I pronounced your name wrong. I probably did. Bad at that. This is a recreation of my isolation photo in Lego. Look at this. It's perfect. You got the prints on the wall. You got my vents up top. The security camera, the clip for my guitar. This is so good. Please find me and send me the full size of this. I want to post it on my Instagram. This looks so good. And it's so creative. You've even got the reflection on the floor. Come on. Brian. Yes. Thank you. So, great job to everyone that participated in last week's photo assignment. Now it is time to give you the photo assignment for this week that we will review next week. So this week's photo assignment is contrast. I'm not gonna say anything more about it. We'll save that for next week. Until then, hit the like button if you like this video, smash it. If that's something that you're into, 2020 style, subscribe if you aren't already, and I will see you in the next video. Peace. Hey, back for just a quick second. Honorable mentions. Come on. We can't do a full episode of photo assignments without honorable mentions. This week in honorable mentions comes from none other than Simon Yao. Corona isolation. Taken for PM photo assignments with the theme isolation, where we are all in lockdown to stop the spread of coronavirus. I just thought it was kind of funny, fitting, cute, unfortunate. Also, trying a new lighting setup, got a little bored, ripped off my grid, got rid of the gel, turned on some different lights, opened the blinds. Yeah, what do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Do you like light mode or dark mode? Light mode, dark mode. I'm kind of feeling light mode right now. A little bit of a fresh twist.